What's going on, everybody? Gamers, this is Nira, and welcome back to some more of the Over the Hedge walkthrough. Well, last time around, I assured you had to get through inside Gladys's house, and today we're going to be tackling Escape, the third mission of the of Over the Hedge. And so we're going to dive straight into it. Before we do that, I'm going to go to the extras menu, and we are going to see what we picked up in the last episode. We didn't actually pick up all that much, but we have our first original comic number one. Look at him, such a simple, carefree, and the only thing he has to do is to frolic. And we're not gonna look at the whole thing now. We didn't get any new music. We did get, however, the escape storyboard and how this was originally scripted to go.
Almost there.
What the?
Oh, good. There you are.
I was just on my way to kill you. Well, well.
Basically, it's just a storyboard of the cutscene we're about to see, and then cave exterior is the concept art for the exterior of Vincent's cave. So it's kind of cool that we can unlock this as we move through and get some collectibles. So without further ado, let's just dive straight into the game.
Almost there.
What the?
Oh, good. There you are.
I was just on my way to kill you. Well, well, I'm impressed. You really outdid yourself this time. Keep this up and you're gonna be just like me. Take what you need. Who cares about anyone else?
Well, I guess when you put it like that. Wow, doing the right things never felt so dumb!
The only glaring flaw I have with that scene, well, actually, I'll explain it after this little bit of dialogue.
Whee! That was fun! Go tell our driver to do it again.
Don't just stand there. Help me bust everybody out of these things. Then just stand there. And don't touch nothing.
Okay, the only glaring flaw I have with that little cut, with that scene, is that arguably the most important cutscene in the entire movie that really shows how far RJ has come as a character, as a person, as a fan, as a friend, as a family member, and that was just so emotionally driven home in the movie, was given like 15, 30 seconds in game, maybe a minute, and it was just kind of like, oh, okay, when you put it like that, whee! In the movie, it was more played out, more like it you could see the emotion. I know it's a game, you have to get to the gameplay, which I guess I should be doing, but I don't know, it's just a little minor nitpick of mine. So, in this level, what you have to do is you have to break the rats out of their cages first, and then kill them. There's 15 rats you have to kill. You don't have to do it, but yes, you do have to do it. There's no secondary objectives this time. You have to defeat 15 rats. And then, after you defeat these rats, you can free your friends from the cages. You can free your friends first, but I find it much easier to go and kill the rats before freeing our friends. Okay, get out of there. Anyway, in terms of collectibles, there's a cookie box up here, CD right next to said cookie box, a chip where you spawn in the corner, another cookie box on the left shelf, as well as a CD parallel, and then a chip directly next to it, and a CD right below. All the collectibles for the van unlocked. So now, once you unlock these cages, you can unlock all of the cages, freeing Lou, Penny, and another one of the porcupines. Okay, I'm getting a little overwhelmed. Time to use my, if you hold down Y, because we're playing as Hammy now, because I didn't mention that, but we're playing as Hammy and Stella now, just as opposed to Verne and RJ that we played in for the first two missions, because there's four players, or four characters you can play as throughout the game, and it alternates each time. For these first four levels, it's a set of characters you have to play as, but once we get into the rest of the game, you can pick which characters you play as. Oh, no, wrong, go away. Tap and press Y to perform a special attack when you're in GRS4. That's what I'm about to do. It did nothing. I was not in range. Okay, fine. Have it your way. I'll just attack them by hand. Now, this portion kind of represents how, like, because I mentioned that the first four levels are tutorial-based levels. This kind of represents the combat-based aspect of the game. Level one had the platforming puzzle element to it, and then number two had the get the food out of the house portion of it, and then I won't explain what the final level has to offer until tomorrow, where I will be covering that. Now you'll notice that there's no button assigned to this one. Yes, there is. It's the one directly across from it. Admittedly, this puzzle stumped me at first too, but the...
Heading up front for a little recon.
the one set to unlock Ozzy is directly across from, or Heather, I can't remember which one it is. But you'll notice they're re-unlocked in minigame. There's a multiplayer mode, or technically the whole game is multiplayer capable, but there's a four-player multiplayer mode known as minigames. And in this minigame, you can do things like driver range, golf course, golf carts, all sorts of fun things. I'm going to be covering all of those later this year as the year kind of wraps up with three of my friends, Armstrong, Dragon Slayer, and Scrubby. We're going to be doing a session where we sit down and just play that for fun. So, but that'll happen when the time comes. It's a very short level, I will admit, but that's going to do for this episode. So, I would like to thank you all for watching. Stay tuned for tomorrow's episode, and until next time, this has been Gaming 16. Signing off, saying hope you have a fantastic, horrible day, and I'll catch you all next time around for some more Over the Hedge. Goodbye! Follow me into the great unknown, where pink flamingos grow. Diet soda flows, and what you take magically regenerates. On supermarket shelves, the ovens clean. Team.